how much better a person can be and do if his or her life is completely surrendered to the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, the first reading is taken today from the book of Deuteronomy, in which we hear the most famous statement of faith in the scripture. It is called Shema Israel, which is an integral part of Jewish prayers. It says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might." It invites a person to realize the fact that our God is one Lord. And if our God is one Lord, what should be our response to our one God? There are two things expected of us. One is at the personal level, where my belief in this Lord is expressed in loving Him. It is interesting to note that the believer is ought to love Him not partially, but with our whole self, that is, with all heart, all soul, with all might. Hence, God is not one of the objects of my love, to whom we give a portion of my heart, my soul, my strength. Rather, He should be the only object of our love. We love Him wholeheartedly. Even in loving people who are dear to us, we ought to love God. He should be the one who is being loved when we love others. Similarly, in the case of our strength, we are asked to spend our whole strength on Him, not a portion of it. In other words, in everything we do, we should please God. All that we do should be directed for the glory of God. The second expectation from us is to teach others the same, those of our household and those who are outside. What are we to teach them? We are to tell them that our Lord is one God and our life should be a complete homage to Him, not partial, half-hearted, one based on profit that we could get from Him. We should teach them, not by mere words, but by being a living example. In the Gospel, Jesus says, "If our faith is even as small as a mustard seed, we can move the mountains." How much better a person can be and do if his or her life is completely surrendered to the Lord. Amen.